Hello, 10th grade class. There's another lesson on the poop and pee theory. There's chapter 1, lesson 1.2 if you want to find it in your textbooks. My voice sounds a bit different today because I'm a little bit sick. It's not coronavirus though, don't worry. Ha 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 ha. Anyways, in today's lesson we'll be reviewing how to calculate poop and pee with variables. You will use this theory for problems that require you to solve for a variable, such as the circumference or the length of the urine stream. One thing that this presentation doesn't mention is that diameter. Diameter is going to be very important in calculating everything that I'm talking about here. Okay, moving on. We'll first start off with the equation from lesson one. Jonathan, I know you don't get this. We'll talk after class about it. By the way, you are failing my class right now, so make sure to not be on your phone this class. I can see you looking down on the Zoom stream. Please stop. Okay, thank you. If you know the theory from last class, you know that if you do all the math, it'll equal 1,000. But usually after this step, you find the radian, and then that's the radian for poop. But this time, we're going to find the circumference based on the grams of feces in the person in question. I'll explain in a bit. Okay. How to solve for poo when given a variable. By the way, poo is a very, it's a very challenging term. It's just a fancy term for poop. I know you haven't heard it many times before, but it's a mathematician's way of saying poop. Anyways, here is a sample equation. Joel ate 3 slices of pizza at his grandma's house. Don't get tripped up on the location, like at his grandma's house. They're just trying to confuse you. After digestion, Joel has 450 grams of feces. Okay. How much does it equal? So, we want to start with the average amount of feces. This theory works off of averages. So, if the average amount of feces is 500 grams, with an average diameter of 2 inches, then the ratio is 500 to 2. The next step is to subtract Joel's feces by the average amount. So, after subtracting, you get 50, and you got to equal it out to both sides of the ratio. That equals 50 to 0.2. Using this new ratio, divide 450 by this number you just got, which is 50, and that gives you 9. And then multiply the other side of the ratio by 9, and then that'll give you 1.8. And our answer is 1.8 inches in diameter. Okay. Kind of simple lesson today. It's only a few slides, so okay. Moving on. After the pizza, he had some salad. After that, he drank 300 milliliters of water. This is where the pee part comes in. It's asking you how much does his pee equal in diameter, and you're probably wondering, how does pee have a diameter? It's talking about the stream, the solid stream that comes out when you pee. So the diameter of that stream is easily calculated. It's basically the same equation as last time. You get the ratio of the averages, which is 400 to 0.8, as you can see right here. Use that and subtract the average by Joel's amount, so that it's 100. And it gives us a new ratio, 100 to 0.2. Now, divide his water intake, which is 300 up here, by the number we just got, which is 100 in our new ratio. Multiply that number, so 300 divided by 100, simple math is 3, and multiply that by 0.2. 3 times 2 is 6, so it's 0.6. That's our answer. Now, you're probably wondering why I mentioned circumference in the first slide, all the way back here, and I'll get to that in the next one. It's really simple. All you have to do is multiply pi by the diameter, and you get the circumference. So we already have Joel's calculations. In his poop, he has 1.8 inches of diameter using this theory, and multiplying by pi gives you 5.652 if you put it into your calculators. By the way, your calculator says if you don't know how to calculate with pi, you can either just do it times 3.14, or if you want to get super exact with it, there's a button on the top left. It says like second or something, you press that, and there's another button, like three buttons below that, and you press that, and then look for a button that has the pi symbol on it, and then you can put in pi. Okay, moving on to his p, all you have to do is multiply 0.6 times 3.14, and you get 1.884. Just a quick review. You take the averages, so write this down. 500 grams is the average, 2 inches of diameter is the average for poop. Just write down these two, and the ratio. And then all you have to do is subtract the first part by the person's feces amount, and then equal out the ratio, and then divide it by the first number, and then multiply the diameter. I know it sounds complicated, but you guys will get the hang of it. You ready for the homework? So, if you guys have questions about the second one, it might seem a little bit intimidating at first, but just follow the equation like normal. She only has 2 grams of feces because she's fasting or something like that. But just follow the equation, and I'm sure you'll get the answer. Remember, 500 minus 2. It might seem like a minuscule number, but that's how you do it. And you're gonna have to know all this. You're gonna have to know all of these. So make sure to take a screenshot or take notes of these. You're gonna have to know this for the finals. The tests are coming up, and all of you are failing. You guys are very, very dumb. I don't know what's wrong with you guys, frankly. That's that. Okay, well, that's the end of the lesson. I hope you guys learned something from this, and I'll come back with another lesson like a day or two from now, covering chapter 1, lesson 1.3. And the rest is kind of extra. You might skip to chapter 1, lesson 2, but okay, that's it. Enjoy your weekends.